Thank you. lot of talking here, but just a warm welcome, and thank you so much for being here. And for those of you who don't understand why I was pointing at somebody up there, because you come to concerts and most of the time the composers are dead, that's the composer of the piece we just played. Professional musicians, band directors, music teachers, professors from Stetson, Stetson alums, just people from Central Florida. It's a really great group of people that I have the honor of working with. And he wrote that for us to play last summer. And then this band, or the combined symphonic and concert band last semester, performed it at the Steinmetz Center. But we haven't played it at home yet, so we decided we'd play it here at home. So thank you for indulging us. Note is this piece on the program, because every other piece on the program was written for the wind band. It was written for a band. The piece that you're hearing next, and you can read a program note about it, but it is a transcription from an orchestral work, and actually originally from an opera, from a long opera by Richard Strauss. And so what you're going to hear here is our only transcription we're doing this evening, but it's a really gorgeous work and a great piece of music that I wanted to share with them, and I love it, so I wanted to play it, so that's why we're here. And they play it really well, so that's why.
Mm-hmm.
see after this that we have an intermission. And you may think, well, we're not that far in. Well, you're right. But the first half is 45 minutes, when we're done with this, they give or take. And the second half is one piece. And it's the same length as the first half, just so you know. But don't let that scare you, because when we get started on it, we'll be done with it, and you won't manage where the time is. Trust me on that. So after, when we're done, we'll take a quick 15-minute just intermission, because we need it. We need some time there. And that way you can stretch and stand a little bit, and you can need it too, between all the stuff that we got going on in this space. So that's why we're doing it. There won't be any playing during that time, so you have your ears have an opportunity to rest during that as well. This next piece on the program, you can read the program note, but let me just put it very succinctly. This is a truly significant work for bands. Written in 1951, so think about how long ago that was. But some of you may be familiar with the composer Paul Hindemith. Some of you may be very familiar with that composer. Some of you may not know that composer. German composer, emigrated here to the United States at the beginning of World War II, and spent and actually taught at Yale University. And so, very prolific composer, wrote this piece for the Army Band, again, as it says in the program notes. And I'm just going to tell you, if it's your first time hearing this piece, I hope it's not your last. But if it is your first time, there's going to be some stuff that we're going to do our best to let you hear everything that's there, but there's going to be some stuff, just like great literature, that you have to go back to again and again and again and again, and great art, visual art, again and again and again to get. It's one of those pieces. So when I say that, I don't want to put you off to it. I just want you to know there's a lot of really cool stuff in it, but some of it is going to kind of go over you a little bit at times just because there's so much happening. But I share that because I love the piece. I'm so glad we get to perform it for you, and we hope you will enjoy it. Paul Hindemith, Symphony in B-flat for Concert. Thank you.
Thank you.
appreciate all your support throughout the year, whether it be for the band concerts, the choir concerts, the orchestra concerts, the chamber ensemble performances, senior recitals, etc., etc., etc. We really do appreciate your support, and for us, it's crucial to have you with us because you're a part of our educational process. So we thank you for taking the time to be here and sharing this evening with us. I talk to the students all the time about sharing the music that we get to work on every day. And you all don't get to see what we do every day, which is okay. But we have a really great time doing that, but we get to connect with the composers that we get to work with their music, whether they be alive, or whether they be in the past, or the ones that are yet to come. But having that opportunity to connect with the composer through their music, and then for us to have that opportunity to share that experience with you is crucial for us, so we thank you for that. Before I introduce our last piece, if you'll indulge me, we have a very important thing that we have to do here. This is an exciting time, but it's a bittersweet time, because this is time when we say goodbye to individuals on this stage who this is their last concert with us because they're graduating or they're going off to do their internship and student teach next semester, etc. We have 24 students on this stage. Yes. 24.
There you go.
Students on this stage, that this is their last concert. And these students, first of all, this has been a great year for the band, for the bands. We've had a great year for all of us working on the stage, and I know there's some in the audience here, our students who were in the band last semester, and most of them are out interning right now, or some have graduated, but most are out interning, and a lot of them are here tonight. It's been a real great year for us as a program, and that's because of these people on the stage and the people who are on the stage for this last semester. And I'm putting it out there, it's always a joy to get to work with them. And so if you're their parents, you've done good, and I appreciate it. I appreciate the opportunity to get to work with your students. But these folks are going on, and these are the folks that were with us their first year, most of them their first year at Stetson was fall of 2019. And then we had big disruptions, as everybody is aware. And they've been with us throughout all that, and they have been such important people to our program, for mentorship, and for just a great collegial spirit. And so we're truly going to miss them, but we're so excited for the things that lie ahead of them and all the great things they're going to continue to do out there and advance their careers, but also make Stetson proud, and we'll welcome them back anytime. So if you'll indulge me just a quick second, we're going to go through, because this is their one opportunity to get their acknowledgement. And so we're going to go in score order, and we're going to start in the flute section. We have Haley McLafferty. Sanchez. saxophone section, we have Mitchell Parker. And also in the saxophone section, and on the next piece, playing bass saxophone, not Barry, bass saxophone, is Joshua Rosenstock. David Maslanka. David passed away in 2017, and if you've come to any of our concerts, you've heard some Maslanka before. It's some music that we like to play. He is a very prolific composer for band, for wind band. And last concert we did, Maslanka's fourth symphony. This is the eighth symphony. We were supposed to do the eighth symphony in April of 2020, but that didn't happen. And so now we're bringing it back, and we're having the opportunity to perform and share it with you tonight. And again, you can read the program note. The reason that David Maslanka's music, I'm biased, I get to pick, so I'm picking it, and I want to do it. But the reason we do it is there's so much in it that connects to people. And I can't put that into words any better than that right now. David Maslanka, we did this piece in 2014. We actually did this, the Stetson Band did this in 2014. And David was here for a week-long residency when we did that. And that was, I dare say, a life-changing experience for everybody in the band at the time, those students that were in the band, and myself included. And I've known David before, but hadn't had the opportunity to just work with him with my ensemble. And he was, but still is, a gracious human being. And you hear that in this music, but you also hear the depth of despair in it as well. So you're going to go on an emotional journey with us tonight. And so I invite you to allow that to happen, if you will. But it's exciting. The journey is exciting. At times it may not seem exciting, you know what I'm saying, right? Just like life. Just like life is that way, right? It does all these things. But you will experience that, and we're so grateful to be able to perform and share with you David Maslanka's Symphony No. 8. Again, thank you so much for being here tonight, and we wish you well as you travel. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.